गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडे वी विल लुक एट विलियम ब्लेक, हिज पोएम्स टाइगर एंड लंदन आर प्रिस्क्राइब फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बीए पार्ट टू इंग्लिश लिटरेचर पेपर वन. फर्स्ट अ लुक एट द बायोग्राफी ऑफ विलियम ब्लेक. William Blake was a 19th century writer and artist who is regarded as a seminal figure of the Romantic age. Seminal means important and having great influence on future developments. So, William Blake was a seminal figure of the Romantic age. His writings have influenced countless writers and artists through the ages. Who was William Blake? William Blake began writing at an early age and claimed to have his first vision of a tree full of angels at age 10. He studied engraving and grew to love Gothic art, which he incorporated into his own unique works. A misunderstood poet and artist and visionary throughout much of his life, Blake found admirers late in life and has been vastly influential since his death in 1827. Early years. William Blake was born on November 28, 1757. In the Soho district of London, England. He only briefly attended school, being chiefly educated at home by his mother. The Bible had an early profound influence on Blake, and it would remain a lifetime source of inspiration, coloring his life and works with intense spirituality. At an early age, Blake began experiencing visions, and his friend and journalist Henry Crabb Robinson wrote that Blake saw God's head appear in a window when Blake was 4 years old. He also allegedly saw the prophet Ezekiel under a tree and had a vision of a tree filled with angels. Blake's visions would have a lasting effect on the art and writings that he produced. The young artist. Blake's artistic ability became evident in his youth, and by age 10 he was enrolled at Henry Parr's drawing school, where he sketched the human figure by copying from plaster casts of ancient statues. At age 14, he apprenticed with an engraver. Blake's master was the engraver to the London Society of Antiquaries, and Blake was sent to Westminster Abbey to make drawings of tombs and monuments, where his lifelong love of Gothic art was seeded. Seeded means it had its roots there. And Gothic is related to the art form of Greece. Also around this time, Blake began collecting prints of artists who had fallen out of vogue at the time, including Durer, Raphael, and Michelangelo. In the catalogue for an exhibition of his work in 1809, nearly 40 years later, in fact, Blake would lambast artists who endeavor to raise up a style against Raphael, Michelangelo, and the antique. He also rejected 18th century literary trends, preferring the Elizabethans, that is Shakespeare, Jonson, and Spencer. Jonson is Ben Jonson and Edmund Spencer, and ancient ballads instead. The maturing artist. In 1779, at age 21, Blake completed his 7-year apprenticeship, meaning training, and became a journeyman copy engraver, working on projects for book and print publishers. Also preparing himself for a career as a painter, that same year, he was admitted to the Royal Academy of Arts Schools of Design, where he began exhibiting his own works in 1780. Blake's artistic energies branched out at this point, and he privately published his poetical sketches, 1783, a collection of poems that he had written over the previous 14 years. In August 1782, Blake married Catherine Sophia Boucher, who was illiterate. Blake taught her how to read, write, draw and color, that is his designs and prints. He also helped her to experience visions as he did. Catherine believed explicitly, meaning completely, totally, without any questions, in her husband's visions and his genius, and supported him in everything he did, right up to his death 45 years later. One of the most traumatic events of Blake's life occurred in 1787, when his beloved brother Robert died from tuberculosis at the age of 24. At the moment of Robert's death, Blake allegedly saw his spirit ascend, meaning rise or go up, through the ceiling joyously. The moment which entered into Blake's psyche greatly influenced his later poetry. The following year, Robert appeared to Blake in a vision and presented him with a new method of printing his works, which Blake called illuminated printing. Once incorporated, this method allowed Blake to control every aspect of the production of his art. While Blake was an established engraver, soon he began receiving commissions to paint watercolors, and he painted scenes from the works of Milton, Dante, Shakespeare, and the Bible. The move to Feltham and charges of sedition. Sedition means the use of words or actions that are intended to encourage people to be or act against the government. हिंदी में अगर हम इसको समझें तो एक तरीके से देशद्रोह. In 1800, Blake accepted an invitation from poet William Halley to move to the little seaside village of Feltham and work as his protege. Protege means a young person who is helped or trained or personal development by an older, more experienced person, usually one who is famous or powerful. While the relationship between Halley and Blake began to sour, meaning they were no longer friendly with one another, Blake ran into trouble of a different stripe, of a different kind. In August 1803, Blake found a soldier, John Schofield, on the property and demanded that he leave. After Schofield refused and an argument ensued means followed, Blake removed him by force. Schofield accused Blake of assault and worse, of sedition. In other words, acting against the government, claiming that he had damned the king. The punishments for sedition in England at the time, during the Napoleonic Wars, were severe. Blake anguished, means in great mental and emotional sorrow, uncertain of his fate. Halley hired a lawyer on Blake's behalf, and he was acquitted, meaning freed, in January 1804, by which time
Blake and Catherine had moved back to London. Later years. In 1804, Blake began to write and illustrate Jerusalem from 1804 to 1820, his most ambitious work to date. He also began showing more work at exhibitions, including Chaucer's Canterbury Pilgrims and Satan Calling Up His Legions. But these works were met with silence, and one published review was absurdly negative. Absurdly meaning unreasonably. The reviewer called the exhibit a play of nonsense, unintelligibleness, that means difficult to understand, and egregious vanity, and referred to Blake as an unfortunate lunatic. Blake was devastated by the review and lack of attention to his works, and subsequently he withdrew more and more from any attempts at success. From 1809 to 1818, he engraved a few plates. There is no record of Blake producing any commercial engravings from 1806 to 1813. He also sank deeper into poverty, obscurity, and paranoia. Obscurity means people were forgetting him, and paranoia means he was afraid, unreasonably afraid of everything, as if people were behind him. In 1819, however, Blake began sketching a series of visionary heads, claiming that the historical and imaginary figures that he depicted actually appeared and sat for him. In other words, they modeled for him. By 1825, Blake had sketched more than 100 of them, including those of Solomon and Merlin, the magician, and those included in The Man Who Built the Pyramids and Harold Killed at the Battle of Hastings, along with the most famous visionary head that included in Blake's The Ghost of a Flea. Remaining artistically busy between 1823 and 1825, Blake engraved 21 designs for an illustrated book of Job from the Bible and Dante's Inferno. In 1824, he began a series of 102 watercolor illustrations of Dante, a project that could be cut short by Blake's death in 1827. His death and legacy. In the final years of his life, Blake suffered from recurring bouts of undiagnosed disease that he called that sickness to which there is no name. He died on August 12, 1827, leaving unfinished watercolor illustrations of Bunyan's Pilgrim Progress and an illuminated manuscript of the Bible's Book of Genesis. In death as in life, Blake received short shrift from observers, meaning people did not talk much about him, and obituaries tended to underscore his personal idiosyncrasies at the expense of his artistic accomplishments. The Literary Chronicle, for example, described him as one of those ingenious persons whose eccentricities were still more remarkable than their professional abilities. Unappreciated in life, Blake has since become a giant in literary and artistic circles, and his visionary approach to art and writing has not only spawned countless spellbound speculations about Blake, they have inspired a vast array of artists and writers. Although Blake was married to an illiterate woman, she helped him print the illuminated poetry for which he is remembered today. Blake's first printed work, Poetical Sketches, 1783, is a collection of apprentice verse, mostly imitating classical models. The poems protest against war, tyranny, and King George III's treatment of the American colonies. He published his more popular collection, Songs of Innocence, in 1789, and followed it in 1794 with Songs of Experience. Some readers interpret Songs of Innocence in a straightforward fashion, considering it primarily a children's book. But others have found hints at parody and critique in its seemingly naive and simple lyrics. Both books of songs were printed in an illustrated format, reminiscent, meaning reminding, of illuminated manuscripts. The text and illustrations were printed from copper plates, and each picture was finished by hand in watercolors. Blake was a non-conformist who associated with some of the leading radical thinkers of his day, such as Thomas Paine and Mary Wollstonecraft. In defiance of 18th century new classical conventions, he privileged imagination over reason in the creation of both his poetry and images, asserting that ideal forms should be constructed not from observations of nature, but from inner visions. He declared in one poem, "I must create a system or be enslaved by another man's." Works such as The French Revolution, 1791, America, A Prophecy, 1793, Visions of the Daughters of Albion, 1793, and Europe, A Prophecy, 1794, express his opposition to the English monarchy and to 18th century political and social tyranny in general. Theological tyranny is the subject of The Book of Urizen, 1794. In the prose work, The Marriage of Heaven and Hell, 1790-93, he satirized oppressive authority in church and state, as well as the works of Emanuel Swedenborg, the Swedish philosopher whose ideas once attracted his interest. At Felfam, he taught himself Greek, Latin, Hebrew, and Italian, so that he could read classical works in their original language. In Felfam, he experienced profound spiritual insights that prepared him for his mature work, the great visionary epics written and etched between about 1804 and 1820. Milton, 1804-1808, Vala or the Four Zoas, 1797, that was rewritten after 1800, and Jerusalem, 1804-1820, have neither traditional plot, characters, rhyme, nor meter. They envision a new and higher kind of innocence, the human spirit triumphant over reason. Blake believed that his poetry could be read and understood by common people, but he was determined not to sacrifice his vision in order to become popular. In 1808, he exhibited some of his watercolors at the Royal Academy, and in May 1809, he exhibited his works at his brother James' house. Some of those who saw the exhibit praised Blake's artistry, but others thought the paintings hideous, and more than a few called him insane. Blake's poetry was not well known by the general public, but he was mentioned in a biographical dictionary of the living authors of Great Britain and Ireland, published in 1816. Samuel Taylor Coleridge, who had been lent a copy of Songs of Innocence and of Experience, considered Blake a man of genius, and Wordsworth made his own copies of several songs. Charles Lamb sent a copy of The Chimney Sweeper from Songs of Innocence to James Montgomery for his chimney sweeper's friends,
and Climbing Boys album, 1824, and Robert Southey, who, like Wordsworth, considered Blake insane, attended Blake's exhibition and included the Mad Song from Poetical Sketches in his miscellany, The Doctor, 1834-1837. Blake's final years, spent in great poverty, were cheered by the admiring friendship of a group of younger artists who called themselves the Ancients. In 1818, he met John Linnan, a young artist who helped him financially and who also helped to create new interest in his work. It was Linnell who, in 1825, commissioned him to design illustrations for Dante's Divine Comedy, the cycle of drawings that Blake worked on till his death in 1827. This was the biography of William Blake. In the next session, we will take a look at the poem Tiger, which is composed by William Blake. Thank you.